Hey guys, today we're gonna look at 7 ways for you to increase your CRS score so that you will get an ITA in the next row. Let's do this together. So guys, I know it's hard to achieve a higher CRS score. I agree and I totally understand. But there's lots of ways where you can improve your CRS score, and today we're gonna take a look at all of them. The first thing that you can do is to improve your IELTS score. Just by managing one CLB level up, your CRS score will drastically improve. Let me show you how that works. Let's say for example that your English level is CLB level 8. So that means 7.5 in listening, 6.5 in reading, 6.5 in writing, and 6.5 in speaking. And with this CLB level, your CRS score is 348. Now, if you guys manage to move one level up, which is CLB level 9, that is 8.0 in listening, 7.0 in reading, 7.0 in writing, and 7.0 in speaking, your CRS score will drastically increase from 348 all the way up to 404, and that is a huge increase of 56 points. Now, if your English level improved much better and you got CLB level 10, which means 8.5 in listening, 8.0 in reading, 7.5 in writing, and 7.5 in speaking, your CRS score will shoot up from 348 all the way up to 416, which is a huge jump of 68 points. So now you know how your IELTS score usually impacts your CRS score. Let me demonstrate this quickly using the online CRS tool calculator. Before we move on guys, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the bell. I appreciate all of the support. Alright guys, so right now we are on the online CRS tool calculator. You can find this link on the description box below. Alright, so for example guys, you are a single applicant of 29 years of age, has a bachelor's degree credential assessment, and your IELTS level is only CLB level 8. So that means 6.5 in speaking, 7.5 in listening, 6.5 in reading, and 6.5 in writing. And with this level guys, your total CRS score is 348. Now, if you guys manage to improve your IELTS score and got a CLB level 9, which means your speaking is 7.0, listening is 8.0, reading is 7.0, and writing is 7.0, your total CRS score will jump from 348 to 404. And guys, now with a CRS score more than 400 points, you are now actually eligible to get a nomination from the province of Ontario. Now, if you guys keep on improving your IELTS score and got a CLB level 10, which is speaking 7.5, listening 8.5, reading 8.0, and writing 7.5, then your overall CRS score will become 416, which is a very, very huge leap of 68 points from 348 to 416. Now, the question guys is, how do we improve our IELTS score? Well, IELTS guys is not that really hard if you answer it in the IELTS way, and you can do that using cohesion. One very important tip that I can give you guys to improve your IELTS score, especially in speaking and writing, is to deliver your answer in a way that the interviewer can follow your thoughts. And this can be usually done through the use of cohesion. So when I say cohesion guys, these are linking words or phrases that connect your sentences so that there is a continuous flow of thoughts and you never digress from the topic. Let me give you an example.
Alright guys, so for example, in your speaking or writing test, you got this question. Why do you want to move to Canada? So your answer guys, implementing the use of cohesion, should be something like this. I want to move to Canada for several reasons. First, I want to give my children a better future. As a matter of fact, I've learned that the government of Canada has made significant investments to ensure all children have access to high-quality early learning opportunities that will give them the best chance to succeed in life. For example, $100 million will go towards early learning and childcare innovation. Second, I wanted to experience how it feels like playing in the snow. As you may know, in my country, Philippines, it is always hot and humid and the temperature never drops below 0 degrees Celsius, so we never experience snow in the city. Finally, I wanted to build my financial well-being in Canada. In fact, moving to Canada will give me a boost in terms of monthly compensation. To illustrate, if I'm getting about $500 a month in my home country, Moving and working in Canada will give me about $2,000 a month, which is essentially 4 times the monthly salary I'm getting from my home country. So as you can see in my answer, guys, I've used a lot of cohesive phrases such as first, as a matter of fact, for example, second, as you may know, so, finally, in fact, and to illustrate. So guys, by using these cohesive phrases and answering it in this way, the interviewer can follow your line of thought and understand clearly what you are trying to deliver, since these cohesive words links your sentences from start to finish and the interviewer does not lose track of your answer. So this is one strategy, guys, that you can use in your speaking and writing exam and will definitely boost your IELTS score, which in turn will improve your CRS score.
The second way of increasing your CRS score is getting a provincial nomination. Actually, guys, I already have a video on how you can get additional 600 points from a provincial nomination. If you haven't watched that video, guys, you can check on the description box below or on the pinned comment section.
Alright guys, so going back to the CRS tool, currently you have a CRS score of 416, and if you guys manage to get a provincial nomination from any province, say Ontario, Saskatchewan, British Columbia, Manitoba, then your answer here will become yes, and if you calculate your score, let's see what happens. You will see that you will get an additional points of 600 under the provincial nomination, which makes your total CRS score jump to 1016.
The third one, guys, is to gain more work experience. Let's take a look at the CRS tool to demonstrate this again with you guys.
Alright guys, so back to our CRS tool, we just removed the points for the PNP so that we have a current score of 416. So what happens, guys, if you actually gain more experience? So right now you have 2 years of foreign skilled work experience. If you gain one more year, then that becomes 3 years or more, and let's see what happens when you calculate your score. So as you can see here, guys, the total CRS score now jumps from 416 to 441, giving you additional 25 points for work experience.
The fourth one, guys, is to improve your education or get a higher level of education. So for example, guys, you only have a bachelor's degree, then you may consider taking up masteral so that you can get a master's degree credential. Let's take a look back to the CRS tool calculator.
Okay, so back to our CRS tool, guys, your current score is 441. So what happens if you decided to take up master's and also your Canadian educational assessment turns out to be a master's degree? So we changed from bachelor's here to master's, and then let's see if we compute our score. So as you can see here, guys, your total CRS score has jumped from 441 to 481. And as you can see, guys, getting a master's degree can actually help boost your CRS score.
The fifth, guys, is to include your spouse in the application, especially if your spouse has a higher level of education and higher CLB level. So in that case, your spouse is going to be the main applicant.
Alright guys, so first let's take a look at your score if you are applying without your spouse, and then let's take a look at your score if you are applying with a spouse who has a higher level of education and a higher CLB level. Alright guys, so you're married and you're applying alone without your spouse and you're 21 years of age. You have an educational assessment of bachelor's degree, a CLB level 9 IELTS score, and a 2 years work experience. And if you calculate your score, your total score will be 404. Alright, so now guys, let's take a look at your total CRS score. If your spouse who has a higher level of education and higher CLB level is going to be the main applicant. So here is the profile of your spouse, 30 years of age, master's degree, has a CLB level 10, has 3 years or more work experience, and then down below here is actually your profile. So you have bachelor's degree and you have your IELTS band, which is CLB level 9. So if you calculate your score, let's take a look at what happens. Now your total CRS score has jumped from 404 to 477, which is a huge increase of 73 points. So guys, if your spouse has a higher level of education and also has a higher CLB level, In order to increase your CRS score, it's better to include your spouse in the application as the main applicant.
The sixth guys is to learn French and get additional points from it.
Okay guys, so let's take a look back at the applicant who is single, 29 years of age, has a bachelor's degree educational assessment, an IELTS score or CLB level 9, has been working for 2 years, and has a total CRS score of 404. So if we guys decided to take up French lessons, learn French, and actually got a CLB level 9 for French, which is the TEF Canada, then if we compute for our CRS score, our score will jump actually from 404 to 483. Wow, that's really a huge jump just from learning French and getting a CLB level 9 for French.
Finally guys, getting a job offer will give you additional 50 points.
Let's go back to the applicant with a total CRS score of 404. And now let's see what happens if you actually got a valid job offer supported by a positive LMIA. So your answer here will be yes, of which skill type, let's say skill type A. And if you calculate your score, now the points has jumped from 404 to 454, which is a really, really huge jump.
So that's everything guys, we've covered the top 7 ways to increase your CRS score, and I hope my presentation is clear. If you guys have a question, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. And for those of you guys who haven't subscribed to me yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that red button, hit the bell, I'll see you guys on my next video, good luck!